In this video, I'm going to show you how to add images to your content. You can pull images from multiple different sources. You can use photos that are located on your personal computer, or images that are already uploaded to the course and are contained within the course content. Finally, you can use the URL of an image that is located on the internet and embed it in your content. So let's take a look at how that's done. Let's say I'm creating a new news item about pyramids, and I wanted to include an image in the post. I can go to this button right here that says Insert an Image and click it. You now see that you have several different choices depending on where the image is currently located. Is it an image that is on your computer? Or in the next two cases, is it an image that's already been loaded into the course? Finally, if you have the URL of the image you want to use, you could just simply embed the URL and it will pull the picture from wherever it is located on the internet. Let's start by adding an image that is already loaded into the course, and it's found in the course offering files. So if I click on that, you'll see that here I have the file structure for my course, and I have a folder called Imported Photos. Yours may be located somewhere else. I click on that and I see here's an image of a pyramid. Now if I want it, and this is a typical mistake, most people go, this is the one I want, and they click on this. This will just open the image or download it. We don't want that. Instead, we're going to click the radio button here and click Select File. This is the alternative text, and you must include something in here. So I'll put Pyramid Giza, and I'll hit OK. And you can see it's added the image. This time, I'm going to bring in a picture from my own computer. So my computer is the default one that is selected, and I'm going to click on Choose File. Now, this is a folder called Pyramids, and I want this image right here. When I click Choose, it's going to do two things. First, it's going to upload the image. It has to upload the image and put it into the course files before it can add it to my news item. So I'll click Upload, and it's asking for the alternative text right now. Pyramid Giza, and hit OK. So now you can see that it's added it to my news item, but it's also done something else. It's added it to my course files. If I ever want to use this image again, I don't have to re-upload it. It's already in the course files. Now, this image isn't the right size, and unfortunately, I'm using the Safari web browser. If you're using Internet Explorer, when you click on an image, you'll get a bounding box and you'll get some handles that'll allow you to resize it. If you traditionally use Safari or a browser like Google, you'll find you can't resize these images, and so you have to make them exactly the right size. The better alternative is just use Internet Explorer when you know you're going to be including images and you need to resize them. Finally, we're going to add an image using a URL. Over here, I have this image that I'd like to include in my newsfeed. So I go back here and I click on Insert an Image. And this time I'm going to select URL. Now it's asking me to enter the URL of the file. So I go back here and I grab the website URL for this image and I copy it. Come back in here and paste. And then I click on Select File. And again, enter an alternate text. And you can see it's added it to my news item. The only thing to consider about this last technique is that if anything ever happens to the website that you're pointing to, let's say the website goes down or the URL is changed, then the image will disappear from your course content. So it's always preferable, if you own the image or you have permission to use it, to upload it to the course files. That way you know it'll always be there. However you decide to do it, here's an image that we've got. And now I've got the image and I want to add some text. So I click here and I start typing. This is, and if I look here, we see, okay, so the text appears at the base of the image. And there's really nothing I can do to change the positioning of the text. You'll often want to be including text and images in the same post or content page or whatever it is you're trying to create. And so in order to align this text with the image and have control over it, we're going to use tables. And I'm going to show you how to do that in the next video.